young people. I just ask that you hear me again, I'll speak. It'd be what you want me to say. Sorry for you trying to agree.
It is.
So, topic was Renata's petition. So I, first start with, what is this petition? The definition of dictionary is a fact or a piece of data from a study of a large quantity of numerical data. In other words, what the vast majority of people think you are will become. The influence of society can potentially pressure us as young people into becoming this particular. A lot of influence, like music, social media, real big, every these days. So that's a friend group, sometimes even family. And I know with me growing up, I was in sports and stuff. I was pretty good at it early age. Carried on pretty much as possible. But a lot of times we feel pressure to be a certain person or impress certain people. So you kind of lose yourself, or you can lose yourself in that process. And I just looking back over my life, I try to kind of see where I might have went wrong. The key thing I can come up with is leaving God out of the situation, not having a real spiritual relationship with God. Going through high school, I was pretty much the man, so to speak, because I was always like a football star. My grades weren't too bad. I got a lot of attention. And with that comes a lot of pressure, you know, for me, girls, a lot of friends, a lot of different people want to be around you for different reasons. And you kind of get addicted to it at some point, you know. So I always had extra pressure to hold that up. And with friends, a lot of times people come for different reasons. Everybody's motives aren't pure. Now, with a lot of young people, I feel like there's something important to be conscious of at an early age. I feel like we'll be able to get ahead of the game knowing. Because as you succeed in life, when you start to get older, you will start to encounter different people. And the company you keep is very important. It's like I think it's the saying, if you hang around 4 millionaires, you hang around 4 idiots. But I mean, it's amazing just seeing you guys here. It's a lot of me working and stuff on the outside. So it's a lot of young kids that won't come to church. They don't want to be involved with it. A lot of them curse God's name, and it's even inspiring to be seeing you guys here. So I just but being statistic, okay, so going to school, I was a football player and stuff, but it wasn't all peaches and cream. At some point, I started being a little knucklehead. I don't know if I always was knucklehead or I just kind of gradually went into it. But being pressured to please other people, you know, friends or girls, or for the ladies, young men, it kind of put me back to where I leaned more in the streets and stuff. And once you get in a place where you see yourself mess up, a lot of us get caught up in that. And then we start to feel like you can't get out of it. But my message today is, it's never too late to turn your life around. A lot of people feel like once the past is what it is, as far as mine, I just keep it real. I've been in jail. I've gotten in trouble, all types of stuff. I think about it, I've probably done it. But for a long time, I felt like my past hunted me. Like I wasn't ready for my past. Or I can't go past a certain level. I wasn't good enough. I wasn't worthy. But a guy named Robbie Pine that I met recently taught me, you gotta learn how to forgive yourself as God will. God has grace on you, so you should have grace on yourself as well. Even with, might be some questionable things, but you know, everybody has their journey. And you shouldn't beat yourself up over. Identifying with it, actually dealing with it is very helpful. And I think a lot of Christian young men, a lot of us are taught not to be too emotional. But that's not a man vibe. Because some of the biggest men, so to speak, that I've seen encourage me to be emotional. They encourage me to feel like crying. Let it out. Deal with your issues. Don't let it just be buried down into you. If you come out at a time that you least expect, you can be very detrimental. So, my message is stay close with God. Always seek to have a spiritual connection with Him. So, with anything that you encounter in life, He's always going to be that extra that you need. But you need extra strength, extra wisdom, extra faith. Even in times, you know, you might be doing everything good and stuff, just go wrong. Like I remember one day it was early in the morning around 5 o'clock. I was dating my oldest child's mom at the time. Now I left her grandma's house. I was getting from her house. I was just getting myself back together, you know, I was in good spirit. And I had a car wreck that I was almost ending my life. It was bad. I don't really remember the car wreck. I know I woke up in a hospital. And for me, being athletic and just always being strong, being able to move, just be active, it was always like me, my personality. For whatever reason, God saw people sit me down. I don't know if it was what I was going to encounter or what, but I broke my legs up and stuff real bad. I couldn't walk for about 3.5 months, and I went through a phase of depression. And through that time, man, I didn't have any good thoughts. I questioned why I was even still alive, especially on phase off stuff. That I still punish myself for, that God probably already gave me for. You know, I thought I wasn't worthy. I thought I wasn't good enough. But if you still here, God has a purpose for your life. You'll see people that might go through similar situations and don't make it out. Or if the situation they go through might not be as bad, and they might be kicked out of here. But one thing I want you to realize, when you do get down on yourself, if you're able to walk in the room and look in the mirror and see yourself in that reflection, God has a plan for your life. He has favor on you.
Yes.
So there's something that you need to see.
Yes.
But yeah, that's a good thing of mine, like getting that understanding and knowing it. Sometimes life is overwhelming and you don't really know what's next. It's like fearing the unknown, so to speak. But it's a scripture I like, and I don't know the whole scripture. I know the one part. But it says, lean not on your own understanding. And that always sticks to me because a lot of times, in my mind, I feel like we'll try to take hold of the outcome. I mean, take control of what the outcome is going to be. Sometimes we just need to fully surrender and live in God's will. Because sometimes when you pray for stuff, sometimes God gives you what you pray for that you ain't ready for. And I think sometimes it'll shake your faith. When God puts you in situations to where you can't do nothing without Him, and you have to seek Him. Sometimes it's rough to go through that. Sometimes it's a life thing. But even in those times, I'm a bit discouraged because, like I said, if you always feel God has purpose in your life, and He'll take you through those situations. Whether, I don't know how to call God like high school. Going through high school, getting ready for college, I mean, y'all going to meet a lot of crowds. Y'all going to do a lot of trials and tribulations. God just not into the real world. But I don't want God to be discouraged. Don't ever feel like y'all alone. That's why I always encourage being in a relationship with God. And even if ain't nobody there, this man do something right here. Even if ain't nobody there, you're going to have your relationship with God. And you won't feel alone. Those hard times, you'll have somebody to lean on. You know, because friends, a lot of friends, growing up, they're going to be conditioned. You know, when it's convenient for them to be there, they'll be there. Or when they see they can get some out of the situation, they'll be there. Not everybody like this, but I'm just going to be aware of those who are like this. You know, their relationship with God, He has a way of getting those people out the way when you need. And sometimes we're emotional people. It's hard for us to cut those ties, which was something I deal with. Having people sitting around a little too long, where the areas that they go through, you start to do stuff that's meant for them to just encounter, because you connected to them, you encounter the truth. Sometimes you'll get the worst end of the stick. So just, you know, keep your relationship with God, and I feel like He'll lead you in the right path. And I just want to encourage every young person in here, stay close to God, always believe in yourself, you're not a statistic. Don't let nobody name with you. God has no name with you, God's child. Say your name with you. It's above and beyond. Thank you.